What is up, amigos? Today we're talking about why cars have sharp rears. And this actually comes at the request of one of you amigos, Sandan Takumberdi, who was talking about, if you look at, for example, this car here, you see at the back, it's quite sharp. They've actually gone to quite a long, great length to make these sharp edges. And a lot of cars these days have it. In fact, I actually went for a walk the other day and specifically looked at how many cars had them. And pretty much no new car that I saw, at least the hatchback, didn't have these. And if you look at other cars, for example, this one, which is a little bit older, it has a much more rounded back. Okay, it's not that rounded, but it's definitely not sharp. So the question is, why do they have sharp rears these days? And there's one major reason and then one potential reason. And we're going to go through both of these. So the first reason is, if you look at the back of a car, so let's say we're looking down on it, we have the back of the car here. It's a hatchback or a it's quite flat at the back. The flow will come around, and if these edges are rounded, it will come here and then it will start to separate, and it will separate at some point along here. Now, where it will separate really depends on quite a few factors. The first one is how fast this fluid is to begin with. Secondly, how rounded this is. Thirdly, what angle the flow is coming in at on the car anyway. So, for example, in this particular case, if the car is driving along and there's a bit of a crosswind, the flow is hitting here, and then it comes along and it's going to be attaching a little bit more here because you have more flow pushing it onto this rear bumper, as opposed to this side, which is in much more of a wake anyway, so this rear bumper is not going to come into effect and the flow separate a little bit sooner. So that means that the wake is going to be more this direction here with the crosswind like this. If the crosswind was like this, for example, then the wake will be more like this direction. And if those are just a straight on wind, then the wake will be a little bit more straight back. Comparing that to a sharp edge back here, well, it doesn't really matter how the flow is coming in, if it's coming in this way or this way. Once the flow gets to this point here, it's just going to separate because the corner here is just way too sharp, the radius of curvature is way too sharp, and the flow is always going to separate right here, so we know that. So what effect does that have on the car? Well, it means that regardless of the crosswind condition or the driving conditions, we know where the flow is going to separate and the general forces on the car now. The side force is going to remain fairly a bit more constant, and as is the drag and the lift because of this predetermined separation point. So that means that the forces on this car won't fluctuate nearly as much as if you had a rounded back here. And that means that it's more stable for the driver and also much easier to design as well, because you don't have to worry about all these different configurations, all these different crosswind scenarios. You don't have to design a car to take account of all these ones. You can just put these sharp edges here, run it for a few different scenarios, see how it performs, and design the car that way. So it makes the car much more stable here. A second reason why we might have sharp rears, and it's not always the case, but it is often the case, is it can reduce drag. So let's say we blow this section up. Let's say we look at it and it looks like this. So the flow is coming along here and it will start to separate along here at some point. But as it goes along this curve, the velocity is going to increase. And we know that from Bernoulli's equation, for example, that if the velocity increases, the pressure drops. And that means that we get low pressure back here. Low pressure. So we have low pressure near the back of the car and on a rear facing surface. Now that means that we are going to have a greater pressure drag because we have a higher pressure upstream on the upstream surface that's going this way. A low pressure on this surface, which we have a component, if we decompose it in this direction. So that means we have a greater imbalance in the pressures, which means a greater drag, and particularly the greater pressure drag. Now, if we have a sharp corner here, first of all, there's no rear surface here that is seeing this change in pressure, this reduction in pressure because of the acceleration of flow. And secondly, we're not getting this increase in velocity anyway because we don't have this curved surface for the flow to go around anyway and accelerate. So we get rid of this potential problem here. So that is potentially going to reduce the drag in this way, mainly the pressure drag. And as we mentioned, these sharper surfaces, these sharper corners, make the car much more stable across its range of operation. So that is why we have sharp rears on the back of a car. So if you like this video, make sure to like it and click the subscribe button. And I'll see you in the next video. Peace, amigos.